Hi everybody, can you hear me? Okay, good. Yesterday we started to learn how to use Salesforce Developer Console. You created an account on Salesforce Developer Console, and then everybody, when you click on debug and open execute anonymous window, you will have a new window. You will type codes over here. When you click on just execute, it will execute all codes. If you select any line, then execute highlighted. It will execute just highlighted parts. Whichever you want, you can use. Both work. Okay. And yesterday we started to learn data types. We learned primitive data types, integer, long, double, what else, date, boolean, id, we learned decimal, we learned those, and we learned date methods, everybody. We learned date methods. Today we will learn date time and its methods. Okay, please open your developer console and create a date time object. This is date time data type. As you know, to create a variable, at the beginning, we need to type data type. This is data type, date time data type. And then you will put a name for your variable. Let us make it current date time one. C stands for current date time one. This is first one. Maybe I will create second. Because of that, I put over here one. Okay. You can type it explicitly, but to save time, you can use just initials. It works, no problem. Okay, current date time. And then we will put equal sign and we will type date time dot everybody. Can you see there are many methods over here? Many methods. Please select from the list now. Can you see that one? Select now, put semicolon. Now means current date time. To see the value of CDT1 on the console, you should type system.debug, select the first one. Let us put over here a label, current date time is, and then I will put the variable name over here. The text between the single quotes will be typed as a label. You will see that text over here. But instead of variable name, you will see the value of the variable. What will be the value of the variable? It will be current date time. Today is 30th of August 2021 and the time is 7:35 p.m. Eastern time. But let us check if Salesforce is using Eastern time or GMT or Pacific time zone. We will see it. Let us execute the code, everybody. Click on execute after typing. There is no issue. When you see loading, it means your code is correct. Click on debug only. Can you see it says Current date time is 2021-08-30. Date is okay. Look at the time. It says 23:36:09. Everybody, why it is telling 23? Normally in the New York time, we have 7:41 or 7:36. But it says 21:36. Why? Because Salesforce returns GMT time, everybody. GMT time, Greenwich time zone. Okay. Open that one again. Let me make it larger. That's it. Okay, that one returned that one. Put a note after now, everybody. Put a note. Returns GMT time. Okay. Salesforce selected a time zone. It is GMT. If you wanna get your local time, it is possible. We will learn it. But if you use now, you will get GMT time. We will, Tuba. We will do everything step by step, no worries. But for now, just I want to teach you data types, okay? Everybody, let us create one more variable. Type date time, current date time 2. Equals to type please system dot look at, can you see there is now method again, put semicolon. Everybody, if you wanna get current date time from Salesforce, you have two options. You can use date time now function. Date time class has a now function. You can use it. Or you can use now function from system class as well. There are two classes to get current date time. That one will return again GMT time. Let us execute the code, everybody. I will do copy paste to make it faster. I hope it doesn't confuse you. CDT2, I will make it 2. Okay, let us execute just highlighted parts. Select last two lines and then click on execute highlighted. Okay, no error. Click on debug only. Can you see? Again, I got Greenwich time. Okay. There are 3 minutes difference because to type that code got 3 minutes. Okay. Everybody, for example, I want to get Eastern time. Let us do it. How to get date time in a specific zone, specific time zone. I will create one more, everybody, date time variable. Let us name it as CDT3. And then, everybody, I will use CDT3.format method. Use it, please. Format. Format method. Put semicolon to the end. And then, Inside the format method, we will use two parameters. This is first parameter, this is second parameter. Inside the second parameter, you will type your time zone abbreviation. For example, for Eastern time, we are using EST. It will give us Eastern time. If you want to learn the time in Japan, you can use Japan time zone abbreviation over here, which is JST. We can use it, but for now, let us do for Eastern time. So, when you use format methods, you will use two parameters. Second one will have time zone abbreviation. First one will have the format, everybody. I want the date time in that format. At the beginning, I wanna see year and then put month, everybody, and then day. This is the year. This is the date format. Let us set time format. I will make it, everybody, HH, put colon, MM, put colon, SS. This is date time format. I will explain what are those. I am sharing the code. Okay. Everybody, as you estimate, WISE stands for year. Uppercase M's are for months. Why are we using uppercase M? Because lowercase M's are for minutes. To separate them from each other, for minutes, we are using lower cases. For months, we are using upper cases. DD stands for days. SS stands for seconds, everybody. Pay attention. Yesterday, I told you format method gives you string. If you review, you will remember. So when I execute that code, I will have a string. In coding, when you get something from a method, you should put it into a container. So I will create a container. It will be string container because format function gives us string. What will be the variable name? Current date time in Eastern. I put any name, current date time in Eastern. If you wanna make it more readable, everybody, after the first one, you can start the words with upper cases. Instead of in lower cases, make the initial uppercase. Instead of EST, make the initial uppercase. Most of the times, they put names for variables in that format. Focus on the format, everybody. Can you see they are lower cases and then uppercase, lowercase, uppercase, lowercase. Everybody, when you look at that image, which I draw over here, it is looking like camel. Camel. Because of that method to name a variable is called camel case format. Okay. When we name a variable, we use camel case system. What is the camel case system? First word will start with lowercase. The others will start with uppercases. This is camel case naming convention. Okay. You can prefer to name variables like that. It is making your name more readable. In coding, readability is very important. Maybe I told it yesterday as well. Okay. This is my variable name. And then I will print it over here. System.debug. Current date time in Eastern time is, everybody, let us put the variable name over here. That one. I should see 7:52, 53, or 51 as a time. Highlight last three lines and then click on execute highlighted. Everybody, if I am fast, you can tell me to be slow. Okay. Click on debug only. Can you see it says 18:47? Actually, it should display Eastern time. Actually, it displayed different thing. What is 18 Eastern daytime? Okay, let us make that one lowercase h, everybody. Uppercase h uses 24 hour system. If you make it lowercase h, it will use AM PM system. Make lowercase make uppercase h in lowercase. Do it, please. Run the code. Okay. That one. Let me put it over here. Maybe I used system because of the ETK 18. I will use date time now. Everybody, let us put a note over here. Make it like that. Okay, I hope everyone could understand the difference between uppercase H and lowercase H. If you use uppercase, it will give you 24-hour system. If you use lowercases, it will use AM, PM, 06, as you see. Everybody, let us use that one instead of System.now, I wanna use datetime.now. Use that one, please. Let us see if there is any difference between them. Okay. Execute the code. Duplicate field. What is duplicate? That one is duplicated. 4:4. The last ones should be CDT4, everybody. You cannot use same name for different variables. Okay, as you see, it is giving Eastern daytime. Let us use JST, everybody, to see Japan. I will copy that one. For Eastern time, we need to use America, New York, I think. Let us make it. Instead of East, EST, let us type America, New York, everybody. America, New York. type that one, American York. It will give Eastern time. Run the code and see what time is displayed. Between New and York, put underscore. Now execute the code. Make it 5 and 5. Okay. Can you see 1951, everybody? I think this is correct Eastern time. Okay. Everybody, could you understand how to use format methods to get in a specific zone? Let us learn the date and time in Japan. Put that one. I will use AM, PM. Because of that, I will make it HH. And instead of America, New York, I will type JST. That one is 6. Highlight it, then execute, highlight it. In Japan, the time is 08:53, but we are not sure if it is AM 8 or PM 8. Let us make it clear, everybody. Let us make it clear. After the time part, leave a space, put just A, everybody. A stands for displaying AM or PM. Execute the code again. Debug only. Can you see in Japan it is 8 in the morning? Okay, this is the other thing, everybody. That AM is coming because of the A. A works for AM and PM, not just for AM. Okay. When you put A, it will display you if it is AM or PM. Okay. For example, everybody, pay attention, please. Look at the CDT file. After time, I will put over here A. Okay. I will change that one to lowercase h. Instead of 19, I will see 07. After the second, I will see PM over here. Because in American New York, now it's PM. Run the code, CDT file. Debug only. Can you see it is telling 07 PM? Okay. Why did I see PM over here? Because I put A over here. Let me put a note. A is for AM and PM. Everybody, for now, I taught you how to get current date time. Sometimes we want to create a specific date time. Okay. Please type date time. Make it CDT7 equals to type date time again. Put that. You will see many methods over here. Please select new instance. Can you see? Everybody pay attention. There are many new instances over here. Look at like that. Can you see over here? First new instance, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one, and sixth and seventh. Okay, there are seven. Skip last three ones. Just focus on first four ones. Everybody, pay attention, please. Pay attention. In programming languages, if you use same names with different parameters, everybody, I am repeating. If you use same names, as you see, function names are same, but the parameters are different. Fourth one has just long data type, a single parameter. Third one has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 parameters. Second one has 1, 2, 3 parameters. First one has 2 parameters. Everybody, if the method names are same, but the parameters are different, it is called function overloading. Okay? Function overloading. Why did they tell overload? Because for a single name, you created many functionalities. Functionalities are overloaded. Because of that, if you see functions with same name, different parameters, you will tell that function is overloaded. Is it clear what the overloaded is? Today, just Erkin is active. What about the others? In Apex, we use function instead of method. Method is in Java. Okay. Function overloading, everybody. Okay. For now, everybody, I will select first one to use, that one. Can you see, I will use second one, pay attention. I will use second one. I will insert year, month, and day. It will give me date time. Let us use it. Select the second one, second new instance. It says, give me the year. Let us make it 1986. I will make the month 9th month. Let us make the day 12. Put semicolon. Okay. By typing that code, I am creating a specific date. Everybody. Okay, specific date. And then I will print it on the console. Let us just print the date. Highlighted, execute highlighted. Debug only. As you see, everybody, this is the date. Close that. Okay. It put the time over here. Yes, it got the hour because I am using date time. Okay. It is putting over here, I think, default. Okay. But if you want to select the time, specific time in the date, let us create one more. Date time CDT 8 equals to date time. Everybody in date time object, every time you will see time. Select the second one. Sorry, third one. This is. Can you see it says year, month, day, hour, minute, second? Let us put it 1986, 9, day, 12, hour. I will make it, for example, 16, minute, 20, second, 33, put semicolon. Okay. And then I want to print it. Make it CDT 8, run the code. Okay, as you see, it tells 2320, why? Because it is GMT, everybody. That one is Greenwich time. Okay, Greenwich time. But if you wanna make it, everybody, if you wanna make it America, New York, you can do it. If you wanna make it Eastern time, EST, Eastern daytime, you can do it, or whatever you want by using formats. But we learned how to use format. I will not use it again. Okay. We are learning how to use new instance. That two ones are enough to use, everybody. Most of the times we will use that one. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, I can. Okay. Okay, let us use one more method, everybody. Create one more object, CDT 8, so 9, equals to date time dot now, get now. Okay. And then pay attention, everybody. I will use one more method, time method, put semicolon. Everybody, inside the date time class, we have time method. Time method, I mean time function, because in Apex we use function instead of method. Time function, everybody, returns time data type. And every time if a function returns a value, we create a container and we put the value into the container. Let us see what will we get from time function. That debug. Just I wanna see that one. Highlight and execute. Okay, good. Everybody, pay attention, please. I made a mistake over here. What kind of mistake did I do? Everybody, when you put a name for a variable, you cannot use Apex names. Some words are keywords in Apex, okay? Some words are keywords in Apex. Apex tells us those words are reserved for me. You cannot use them. Time is one of them. Okay. So what can I do? I will make it T9. Time 9. This is date time 9. This is time 9. Make it time 9. Okay. Let us put a note over here. For variables, we cannot use, everybody, we cannot use keywords for variable names. Let me make it like that. For variable names, we cannot use keywords in Apex. Okay. For example, over here, time is a keyword. What else, everybody? For example, public is a keyword. What else? If is a keyword. Switch is a keyword. There are many keywords, okay? We cannot use them as variable names. If you use, you will get notification. No need to memorize. But when you type codes, you will understand. Time is a reserved. Why? Because it is used in time function, everybody. It is used in time function. Highlight and then execute highlighted. Can you see, everybody? It is giving me that one. This is everybody 17. What is 17? Pacific time, everybody. PST. Some methods are returning Pacific time in Salesforce because the center of Salesforce is in California. It is in Pacific time, okay? It is using Pacific time. It is not important. By using format, you can convert it. But you should know that one. In Salesforce, there is a method which is a time method. It returns time. This is hour, minute, second, millisecond, everybody. That one, the last one is millisecond. Okay. This is time method. Okay. I think for date time, that's enough. Again, everybody, after typing date time, put dot over here and look at the methods. Yesterday, we learned add days. No need to repeat. Skip add error once because we will use them when we learn exceptions. For now, you didn't learn what the exception is. But when I teach you exceptions, we will use them. We learned add hours, or you can estimate the functionality of add hours. For example, for now, the time is 8. If you wanna add 2 more hours, use add hours. Add minutes, add months, add seconds, add years, okay? This is date. I taught you how to use time. We can do an example about date, everybody. Date GMT, that one is returning the date in Greenwich, day GMT, day of year. Yesterday we learned it. Day of year in Greenwich. Those are very specific methods. We learned format. Can you see? Format method is overloaded, everybody. There are 3 format methods. We used first one. We used third one. Second one, if you use second one, everybody, it will give you Greenwich date in the given format. You can put over here a format. For example, it is using forward slash. If you want, you can put hyphen between them. It works. You can use format. Format GMT, format long. Skip that one for now. Get time. It is getting time, similar with time method. We learned is same day yesterday. Millisecond, if you want to get millisecond, you can use that one. If you want to get minute, month, I think from the names of the functions, you can estimate the functionalities. No need to make examples for all. If I do, it will take too much time. Okay. We used now. Yesterday, we learned parse. Second method will give you the seconds. We learned time. Value of, yesterday we used value of. Okay. Please, after the class, until tomorrow, until the class to Sunday, do at least one example from all and see what they are doing. Okay. During the class, that's enough. Okay. Now, everybody, we will start to learn string. String is very important data type, everybody. String data type. Okay. Let us create a string data type. We will type string. I will name it as str1 equals to, between the single quotes, you will type over here, apex, for example. Let us make it apex is easy. Okay, apex is easy. By typing that code, I created a string. Let us print it on the console. System.debug. Okay. Remove that one. Put str1. Okay. Highlight and execute. Can you see? String is over here. Apex is easy. That one will print, apex is easy. We used string, I think it will be easy for you. Okay. Everybody, there is a method. Let me put over here like that. Abbreviate method. Okay, abbreviate method. That one is maximum width. You know the meaning of abbreviate. You will make the string shorter. For example, instead of Florida, we are using FL. I shortened the Florida. Abbreviate function is used to shorten a string. Okay, inside the parentheses, you will put maximum length. Let us do it, everybody. I will create a string. Do it together with me, please. str2 equals to, and then I will type over here, hello Salesforce. That one is my string. Pay attention. str2.abbreviate. Okay, abbreviate. Put semicolon. Let us put over here 10, everybody. Okay. So when I put over here 10, it means I want str2 At most 10 characters. Normally that one has more than 10 characters. If you use abbreviate with 10, it means you wanna see that string at most in 10 characters. Let us, everybody, do that one. There will be something different, Fethullah. I will make it abbreviated str2. Can you see I used camel case? Abbreviate, this is the second word. I started with uppercase S. This is camel case, everybody. Let us see camel case on the console. Debug. Just I wanna put that one. Okay. Highlight and execute. Okay. Can you see, everybody, it put ellipses, three dots over here. Let us count the characters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There is space, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Everybody, together with the three dots at the end, it will be 10 characters. Okay. This is the functionality of abbreviate methods. Put a note over here. Together with three dots, it will have 10 characters. Okay. Don't forget, in programming languages, space is a character like alphabet. Space is a character like digits. Okay. Don't think like that. Space is not visible. We will not count it. No. All programming languages count space as character. Okay. I hope everyone could understand the functionality of abbreviate. I am proceeding. One more string method, everybody. Again, it is abbreviate, but it uses two parameters. First one will be maximum width. Second one will be offset. Offset means skip, everybody. Offset means skip. I will tell to Apex, hey, Apex, maximum width will be 8, for example, but I want you to skip first 6 ones, for example. Let us do it, everybody. I will create again same string, copy and paste that one. Change the name to str3, okay? And then str3.abbreviate, put semicolon. I want 8 characters in total, but I want Apex to skip first 6 characters. Let us estimate what will I get, everybody, from here. If I will skip first 6, H will not be taken. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That highlighted part will be skipped. So I will see S at the beginning. I will see S, okay? Everybody pay attention. To declare some characters are skipped, Apex will put 3 dots over here. Okay. When you see 3 dots over here, you will understand some characters are skipped. So 3, 4, and then I will have 5, 6, 7, 8. In total, it should be 8 because of that 3, 4, 5, And then there will be three more. In total, it is eight. Okay. In total, it has eight characters. Okay, let us see on the console. I will create a container again. Make it three, and then I want to print it over here. I am using copy-paste. You can use it as well. Highlight and execute. Can you see, everybody? It's that one. Instead of three dots, you can use ellipses, everybody. That one. Three, five, eight. I think second usage of abbreviate is clear. As you see, everybody, abbreviate same names, the parameters are different. So abbreviate method is overloaded, or abbreviate function is overloaded. A bit slow. Okay, let me share the code. Yes, I know. Doing more than one thing at the same time can be a problem. Functions, Amber. I taught Java for many years. Because of that, I am using methods accidentally. Normally, it is function. When I tell method, you understand function, okay? But I will get used to use function instead of methods. Okay, I think that's enough to wait. Okay, another method, everybody. From me or from someone else, Ali? Oh my gosh. Maybe before Java, I was teaching another programming language. Okay. Capitalize, everybody. Actually, if I don't do any example for that function, you can understand the functionality. Function names are summarizing the functionality, actually. Nazmiye over here, 10. Normally, that string has, for example, 16 characters. When you print that string directly, you will see 16 characters. When you put over here 10, it means you are telling to Apex, hey, Apex, I wanna see just 10 characters. But don't forget, 10 characters will contain three dots at the end. Because of that, from the beginning, you will see 7 characters. In total, it will be 10. Is it clear? Okay. Can you see, I put over here 8. In total, I have 8 characters, but 3 of them are dots at the beginning, 3 of them are dots at the end, so you will be able to see just 2 characters different from dots. Okay. Okay, capitalize. Every time, Mehmet, three dot means there are some things. For example, let me put over here, for example. Yes, it means it's continuing. It is good, Ali. After essay, it is continuing. How many characters are there? It is not clear, but there are some characters. It can be one, it can be ten. We don't know. Okay, everybody copy. Tuba, do copy paste to make it faster. Just change the name, str4. Okay, and then let us use str4.capitalize. Put semicolon. Okay. What will capitalize do, everybody? It will change all characters to capitalize. Or just first character. Let us make all of them in lower cases to understand better. Okay. Make all characters in lower case. Make that one. And then let us create one more container. Capitalized. Everybody, capitalized str4. Okay. This is the name of the variable. I will print it. Capitalized str4. Put it over here. Now, let us execute. I think you will surprise. Can you see, everybody? All lower. Let us check this one. Actually, everybody, can you see it was like that? It happened like that. What happened, everybody? What happened? Just it is making first character capitalized. Everybody, change force to lowercase f. It will be better to understand. Okay. So don't forget, capitalize method converts just first character to uppercase. Okay. Let me put an explanation over here. Converts just first character, just first character to uppercase. Not all. It is converting just first character. Yes. First character. Okay. Erkin, look at the string. All characters are in lowercase. When you use capitalize method, it is converting first character to uppercase. Execute. What is execute? We will learn it, Ajan. You got all in lowercase. Maybe you made a mistake. Copy and paste my code, test it. Char at method. Char at index. From the method name, you will understand that function, everybody, that function will give us character at the given index. Pay attention. For example, in Hello Salesforce. That one is index 0, index 1, index 2, index 3, index 4. Everybody, don't forget, indexes start from 0. Okay. Don't start to use indexes from 1. Every time indexes start from 0. Just it is different in SQL, but in programming languages, indexes start from 0. Everybody. So if I put over here 2, what do you think? What will I get from the function? Yes, as you see, at index 2, I have L, everybody. If I put 2, I will get L. If I put 3 over here, or not 3, 0. If I put 0, what will I get? I have H at index 0. So I will get H, lowercase h. Everybody, pay attention, please. Apex is case insensitive programming language, but string is case sensitive. Every time string values are case sensitive. Because of that, h and H are different. You should be careful about sensitivity. Okay. Let us use it again. I am creating a string over here. I will name it as str5. I will make it hello Salesforce. I made H, S, and F in uppercase, and then I will use str5.char at, everybody, char at put semicolon. Let us type over here 7 or 6. Please estimate, don't execute. What will I get from here? Okay, pay attention. Everybody, pay attention. You think it will give you S. Let us check. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nazmiye, you should start to count from 0. It is index. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. S. No need to tell, sorry. Okay, S. This is S. Everybody, pay attention, please. Char at function returns the ASCII value of S. It will return ASCII value of S. What is ASCII value? If you know Java, you are familiar with it, but I will explain. Pay attention, everybody. It will return ASCII value of S. Let us execute and then talk. Everybody, ASCII value will be an integer. Because of that, I will create an integer container. Let us name it as the value v1. Okay, make it v1, everybody, value 1, and then print it system.debug. Okay, print v1. I will see an integer. Execute the code, everybody. It is taking time. Okay. Can you see it returned 83, that one? So So from here, I will get 83. Everybody pay attention. I told you programming languages has development kits. In the first class, I tried to explain. In the first, just for now, listen, everybody. In the first class, I tried to explain. You will type your codes by using some English words. Integer is an English word. String is an English word. Char at English words, everybody. You will type your codes by using English words. But Apex Development Kit, everybody, ADK, Apex Development Kit, will take your codes, will take those, and then it will convert them zero ones, everybody. You will have many zero ones. Everybody, zero and one are numbers, but you are using letters over here. How can development kit convert letters to digits? How can do it? Every character in programming languages has number values, like that, 83. You are typing over here S, but development kit will accept it as 83, everybody. You are typing S, it is understanding 83, okay? It is understanding 83. To convert 83 to zero ones is very easy. If you know math a little bit, you will remember converting base 10 to base 2. You will divide 83 by 2. That one, 82. Do subtraction 1. And then divide 41 to 2. It will be 4D. There is 1. And then divide 20 by 2. 10, 20. 0, everybody, this is. Divide 10 by 2, 5, 10. Remainder is 0 again. Divide 5 by 2, 4, 1. Okay. Divide 2 by 2, 0. Remainder is 0. This is that one. Okay, everybody. You will get those from right to left, as you know, those are. So according to Apex, everybody, you typed S, but actually it is 83. 83 is actually that one. 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. Okay. When you type S, Apex will use it like that one. For every character, Apex is doing that operation, everybody. For us, it is taking too much time, but Apex is working with speed in electricity. It is being so fast. Okay. Could you understand why Apex is, why programming languages are using zero and ones, everybody? Why programming languages put ASCII values for every character? Otherwise, it is impossible to convert S to zero ones. To have zero ones, you need a value, integer value. And then converting it to zero one is easy. Okay. Everybody, do Google. Please open a Google browser. Type over here ASCII table. Press enter. Open that one. Okay. Let me make it larger. Look at the values, everybody, over here. Where is S? Can you see the value of S is 83? That one. Okay. Yes, ASCII values are numbers. Can you see, Önder? For all characters, there is a value. When you put parentheses, opening parentheses, it is for D, for Apex. Apex doesn't know opening parentheses. It knows it is 4D. When you put space, it is 32. Because of that, I told you, space is a normal character for Apex. Can you see? S is 83, space is 32. Space is a normal character. Don't think, I don't see space, it is not character. It is character. Okay. For null, everybody, at the beginning of Apex class, I told you, when you create a variable, Apex will put null for them. Can you see? Null has value zero as ASCII value. Okay. Pay attention, everybody. Pay attention. Can you see those are upper cases? It is starting from A, ending at Z. Value of uppercase A is 65. No need to memorize. Just, I want you to be familiar. Because when you put single quote, Apex accepted as an image and print it on the console. Everybody, pay attention, please. Uppercase A is starting from 65 and upper cases are ending at 90, everybody. So all uppercase letters are between 65 and 90. Look at the lower cases. Those are lower cases, A, Z. Okay. It is starting from 97, ending at 122. No need to memorize. Just I want you to see that one. Everybody, upper cases ASCII values are less than lower cases ASCII values. Okay. This is weird. So if you tell to Apex, order those, everybody. Order those, for example. Which one will be the first if you order? Uppercase A will be the first. Why? Because programming languages put the elements in order in ascending order as default. If you don't tell them put the elements in descending order, it will put the elements in ascending order automatically. If the value of uppercase is less than the value of lowercase, uppercase will be the first. After A, which one will come, everybody? B will come. Can you see? Upper cases are being at the beginning, and then C will come. After upper cases, you can sort lower cases like that. Okay. Alphabetical order in programming languages are like that because upper cases ASCII values are less than ASCII values of lower cases. That ASCII table is common in all the world, everybody. If you go to Japan, in Japan, the value of uppercase S is 83. It doesn't change. And yes, uppercases are lower than lowercases. Everybody, pay attention, please. We are using UTF-8 characters. UTF-8. UTF-8 means English alphabets. Okay. As you see, in that ASCII table, there is no Ç, there is no Ş. They are in Turkish. Those are English alphabet, everybody. Because our system is using UTF-8. But if you wanna put Japan alphabets if in your programming language, you need to change UTF-8 to another thing. I don't know their code. And then in the ASCII table, you can see Japan alphabet and their ASCII values. But in UTF-8, as you see, our ASCII values are starting from 0, ending at 127. The last character is delete. The first character is null. If you can be familiar about ASCII table, it will be good for you. But no need to memorize anything because you can find from Google that table. I think someone surprised because in Java, everybody, char at was returning. Char at was returning character, but in Apex it is returning, everybody, it is returning ASCII value. This is the difference. It will return ASCII value of S. Okay, it is break time. 10 minutes break time. After 10 minutes, we will go on to learn string methods on Apex. See you. Okay, everybody, break time is over. From the string data type, we learned abbreviate methods, capitalize method, char at function, I shouldn't tell method, function, everybody. Everybody, when you use capitalize, it will convert just the first character to uppercase. But sometimes we may want to convert all characters to uppercases. Let us do it, everybody. After capitalize, let us put that one to uppercase function. Okay. Let us copy that one. I will name it as str5. Okay. Make it str5 and then I will change that one. str5 and then str5 dot to uppercase method. Method name is very clear. It will convert all characters to uppercase. Of course, it will give me a string. Let us create a container uppercased str5. This is my container name. And then I will see it on the console. Okay. What is my estimation over here? I wanna see hello sales force in uppercases. Execute the code. Back on me, can you see? It is all in uppercases. Okay. If there is two uppercase, of course, there is two lowercase. Two lowercase function. I will copy that one, paste it over here. str6, change all 5s to 6s, And instead of two uppercase, use two lowercase function. Okay, that one will be lowercase str6. When you execute that code, all characters will be in lower cases, but they are in lower case. Let us update it, everybody. I will put that one over here. Okay. Can you see all characters are in upper cases, but over here I should see all characters in lower cases. Let us test. It is slow. I want to make that one lower again. Yes, thank you, Erkin. Okay, as you see, all are in lower cases. Okay. This is 7, str 7. Okay. Everybody, in string class, there are many methods. It takes too much time to check all of them one by one. I will teach you most common ones. Okay. Substring function. This is very important and commonly used function, substring function. Let me copy that one. This is str8. It is hello says false. Okay. Everybody, I wanna get just second word from the string. I don't wanna see hello, I wanna see just Salesforce. To do it, you will get the string container and then you will type substring, put semicolon to the end, and then index 0, index 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That one is at index 6. I will type over here 6. That one should return me just Salesforce. By putting index over here, you are telling to Apex, hey Apex, start from index 6 and take the characters to the end. Okay, the meaning of substring is that one. You put 6 over here, it will start to take the characters from index 6 to the end. So I will get Salesforce. But that one is giving me a string. I will create a container for it. String, let us make it sub str8. Okay. And then I will print it on the console. Execute highlighted. Can you see? I have just Salesforce, everybody. This is very common method. You should learn how to use it. Okay. Is this clear, everybody? Okay. There is one more substring method. It is overloaded, everybody. That one is using just starting index. First substring method is using starting index. Second substring method is using starting index and ending index. Okay, both. But everybody, starting index is inclusive. Let me put a note over here. That one is inclusive. Is inclusive. As you see over here, I put 6. 6 was S. It gets S, everybody. It is inclusive. But ending index is exclusive. Every time it is being like that. In programming languages, if you have two indexes in a function, first one is being inclusive, second one is being exclusive. Of course, there can be some extra situations, but I can tell 90% it is like that. First one is inclusive, second one is exclusive. Okay, copy that one. str9, everybody. And then I will copy that one as well. Paste it over here. Just change the names to 9, 9. Everybody, I wanna get just sales. I don't wanna see hello. I don't wanna see force. I wanna see just sales. So 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I will type over here 11. I need 10. I typed 11 because 11 is exclusive. If you type 10, you cannot see lowercase s. If you wanna see lowercase s, you should make it 11 because that one is exclusive. Okay. Put that one over here, make it str9. From here, I should get sales. Test it. Can you see? I have sales. I hope it's clear. Second usage of substring. Okay. Last one. Okay. Look at my screen. Everybody, this is index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Space is 5. That one is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. F is 11. Okay, that one is 11. Pay attention. When you put over here 6, it means the character at index 6 will be inclusive. Okay. If you put over here 11, it means 11 will be outside the selected part. Because of that, 11 will be over here. Okay. If you need sales, can you see it is starting from 6, ending at 10. To be able to get 10, you need to type over here 11 because it is exclusive. When you execute the code, it will give you the characters inside the rectangle sales. Is it clear? Everybody, there is one more usage of substring. Type, please, substring after. Okay. Substring after. You will put over here character. Copy that one again. Copy all, everybody. Copy all. We will update it. Okay. Make it str 10. 10. 10. And then 10. After copying and pasting, change all nines to 10. And instead of substring, I will use substring after. Substring after. Open, close, parentheses, put semicolon. Everybody, inside the parentheses, I will put E. Okay. I will put E. What will happen? Can you see? I have 1, 2, and 3 E's. Okay. I have 3 E's over here. That function, everybody, that function will look at the first occurrence, okay? First occurrence of the E, it is that one. And then it will return the characters after the first occurrence of E. Okay? You put over here E, it will find all E's. And then it will return all characters after the first occurrence of E. Let us execute and see. Can you see? After E, all characters are over here. There is no E. It returns the highlighted part. Okay. Copy all. Paste it over here. Substring before. Substring before. I think you can estimate the functionality. Make tens 11, okay, and change after to before over here. Let us put L over here. Instead of E, I will put L. Okay, pay attention. Everybody, I have 1L, 2L, 3L. L, that one. If you substring before, it will find the last occurrence, okay? Last occurrence, and it will give you all characters before last occurrence. So you will get hello SA, okay? You should get hello SA on the console. Before the last occurrence of the given character. So what is our estimation? That part. Execute the code. Before first occurrence. It was the other method, after last, there was after. Okay, everybody, that one, let me explain again. There is one more method, before last, after last. Okay, pay attention, I will explain again. There are three L's over here. First L, second L, and third L. It will find the first occurrence of L, that one, and it will return the characters before the first occurrence. Because of that, you will get HE. Okay, that's it. But there is one more method which is doing what I explained before that one. Let us copy it, everybody. Copy that one. Paste it over here. It is substring before last. Okay. If you put last, it will get the last occurrence and it will return the characters before the last occurrence. Make it last and change 11 to 12, everybody. Make them 12. Now you will get hello SA from here. Okay. Hello SA. Execute the code. Can you see? It is that one. You will get it. I hope that one is clear. Before and before last. And there is one more last method. It is after last. It will give you the characters after the last occurrence of a specific character. Copy that one, put it over here, change before to after, everybody. Those will be after, make that one 13, 13, 13, and then 13. Let us estimate what will we get. There are three L's, first one, second one, and third one, okay? After last occurrence, so it will find the last occurrence of L, and then it will return the characters after the last occurrence. So I will have ES force over here. Okay. ES force. That was. Check it. Can you see? ES force. Okay, we learned that once. Okay. We have enough time. Okay, everybody, one more method, which is trim method. Trim. For example, you are asking user to enter his name. Everybody, pay attention. You are asking user to enter his name, but user is not familiar with the computer, with the keyboard. To type his name, maybe he will press space a couple of times. After making sure, he will start to type his name and then to make it sure, he will press on space a couple of times like that. Okay, remove that from here. Can you see? I asked user to type just his first name and last name, but he put spaces at the beginning. He put spaces at the end. You cannot tell to the user, don't put space at the beginning, don't put space at the end. User cannot understand technical details. What can you do? You can remove them and make the insertion correct like that. Okay. Trim method is used for that task, everybody. It removes spaces from the beginning and from the end. As you see, the space in the middle exists. It is not removed. Just the spaces from the beginning and from the end will be used, will be removed. Okay, let us do it, everybody. I will create a string. It is str14 equals to, let us put a little bit space, Alican, and then a couple of space. Remove that from here after putting spaces. Put semicolon. Let us print str14 on the console. That debug. str14. And then I will use trim and print it again. Let us use trim, str14.trim. Put semicolon. Of course, after using trim function, you will get a string. String, I will type trimmed str14. Okay. And I will see it on the console like that. Type that code and then execute, please. Okay, I am executing. Can you see, everybody? In the first one, there is space. Can you see over here, there is space? Okay, but in the second one, no space because it is trimmed. Over here, there is space as well, but it is not visible. That one has no space at the end. Okay. Trim is used commonly, everybody. If your application asks user to insert his first name, last name, password, you need to remove spaces from the beginning and from the end, because otherwise, the name will be like that. Space, 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 Ali. Apex will understand the name of the user is space, 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 Ali. And the name of the last name of the user is John, space, 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 space. Okay, but we don't want it because his name is Alican, just Alican. Okay, that one will give you but this is just Alican. Okay, no space at the beginning and at the end. But don't forget the spaces in the middle will not be removed. Okay. Everybody, one more method, you will like it, I think. Reverse methods. From its name, you will understand the functionality. It will reverse the string. Okay, I will get Alican. Okay, remove the spaces manually from here. Okay, and then str14.reverse. Put semicolon. Reverse method will give me string. After reversing Alican, I should see notch ila on the console. Let us create a string container. I will name it as reversed str14. Okay. And then I will print it. That debug. From here, I should see NAC space ILA, that one. Okay. execute. I forgot something. It is 14. Let us make them 15. 15. Yes, I changed them to 15. Is there any else problem? Nope. It should work. It is working. Can you see? It is reversed, everybody. Okay. I will teach you three more string methods, and then I will teach you how to create a class and how to type our codes in a class. On Sunday, we will go on to learn more string methods. Maybe it is boring you. You should learn those. We will learn more about strings. How many string methods did we learn? We learned 14. Okay, let us learn three more. No, Friday we don't have. Next week our class will be Sunday and Friday. This Friday do we have? Did you check the schedule? Could you see my class on Friday? I think they are putting classes for me without asking me. Okay, if there is a class on schedule, of course, we will be together. No worries about it. Okay. But I will ask to Mr. Mehmet Efe, why did he type class? Okay, everybody. After learning reverse, there is one more important method, which is function, replace function. Replace function, everybody. From its name, you can understand it will replace another character for a specific character. For example, instead of I, you wanna put A. You don't want Alican, you want Alacan. For example, you can do it by using replace methods. Let us use that one. Okay. And then create string replaced str 16. Make it 16. Okay. And then, everybody, for str16, I will use replace function. Pay attention. I wanna change I to A, everybody. So, put I, and then comma, put A. First one will be changed to second one. And then system.debug print it on the console and see the output. Can you see it is Alacan? You will get from here Alacan. Everybody, what do you think? Can I put a single character instead of two characters? Instead of Li, I wanna put just A. Can I get that one? Let us test it, everybody. Execute. look at the output. Can you see it is working as well? So when you use replace method, if you want, you can put a single character instead of multiple characters. Or instead of 10 characters, you can put 3 characters. It works, no problem. The number is not important. Okay. Everybody pay attention. What do you think? Instead of a single character, can I put multiple characters? I mean, can I do 2, 4, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6? I will check that one. As you see, it is not giving any error. It worked, everybody. There is no any issue. Okay. Pay attention, everybody. I wanna delete. Let us make it Ali Cani. Okay, Ali Cani, like Iranian name. Rafsanjani var. There is Rafsanjani. This is Ali Cani. Everybody, what do you think if do that one? What will be my output? Instead of I wanna put A. What will be the output? Yes, Nazmiye and Erkin is correct. This is Alacana. Okay. Replace method, everybody. Replace method changes all I's. Not just the first one, not just the last one. All I's will be changed to A. Okay. All I's will be changed to A. Let us see it on the console to make it sure. Can you see? There is no any I. Everybody, if you wanna delete, yeah, there is Tuba, there is. Everybody, if you wanna change a single character from a string, you can use replace method. It will change all. For example, in a book, everybody, in a book, you put all book between two characters, and then you wanna change all Ali's to Mehmet in the book. Just put over here Ali, put over here Mehmet. In the book, all Ali's will be changed to Mehmet. Let us do it. Ali Cani, Ali is good. Ali is here. I typed something. I have three Ali's. Assume that this is a book, everybody. After using that method, all Ali's will be Mehmet in the book. So your output will be like that. It is very easy to do updates in strings, everybody. Because there are many useful methods. Execute, you should see Mehmet 3 times. Can you see? All of them are Mehmet. It is good. Okay. One more thing, everybody. For example, let us put over here one more comma. I wanna remove all commas from that string. How can I do it? Instead of Ali, I will put comma. Instead of Mehmet, I will put nothing. If you put nothing for comma, it means you are removing commas from your string. For example, you have a book, everybody, and you want to delete Ali word from the book. Put over here Ali, put over here nothing. It will remove all Ali's from the book. So when I execute that code, I shouldn't see any comma over here. All should be removed. Run the code. We use replace method many times to remove a specific character from strings. For example, everybody, you have prices like that, 12.99, for example, that one. This is price of the product, but you wanna do mathematical operations for the price. For now, you cannot do it because there is dollar sign. A number shouldn't have dollar sign at the beginning. There is dot over here. A number shouldn't have dot. If it is decimal, it may, but most of the times we prefer to use integers. What will I do? That one is a string, everybody. By using replace method, that one, I am telling to Apex, hey, Apex, when you see dollar sign, put nothing for it. And then I am creating method chain. When you use that, when you see that over here, use nothing for it. If you type that code, you will have 12.99. But 12.99 is a string, everybody. That one is not number yet. This is string. Yesterday we learned by using parse method, everybody, by using parse method, parse 12.99, you can convert it to integer, it is 12.99. And then you will do mathematical operations. If you wanna calculate total product prices, you can do it, okay? When you purchase products on Amazon, the prices are displayed like that. But when you select the products, it is doing mathematical operations and it is telling you $213, for example. How it is doing addition operation with that kind of data, behind those are executed, okay? Behind the website, it is using replace, it is using parse, and then it is doing mathematical operations and you are able to see total price over here. Okay. To make it integer, Tuba, if you, because sometimes when you put that parse method, doesn't work with that. Parse method works just with digits. That is not a digit. Okay. Okay. We learned replace method. There is another, but let me teach you one more method, everybody, which is very common. Length method. function, I mean, length function. From the function name, you can estimate it will give you the length of the string, everybody. What is the meaning of length of the string? The number of characters. Returns the number of characters in a string. Okay. Let us create a string, everybody pay attention. Okay, let us check. I will put that over here to make it more sensible. Okay, and then everybody, str16.length function, that one. Length function will give you an integer because I told you length function returns the number of characters. Number of characters is integer. Let us make it 17. Okay. So I will create an integer container. I will name it as num of char. Okay. Number of characters, length function, that one. Let us print system.debug and then number of characters is that one. Okay. Execute. Let us see how many characters are there in it. It is 35. Okay. Everybody, when you use Microsoft Word, at the bottom on the right, you can see the number of characters or the number of words. It counts by using a function like that. If Microsoft Word is created by using Java or by using Apex, it means it is using length function behind. But if it is created by using another programming language, of course, it has a function similar to length. Okay. That one. If you put a book between two single quotes, you can count all characters in the book. It can give you 10,000 just after clicking on execute button. That's it. Okay, let me give you a task, everybody. In the given string, count just the letters. What does it mean, letters? For example, if the string is like that, I don't want to see comma, I don't want to see dot, I don't want to see spaces, I want to see just the letters. Okay. I will give you the string. This is string. How can you do it? This is 18. You have 3 minutes waiting for you. Okay. I don't know if the 3 minutes are okay. Everybody, if I don't wanna count, pay attention please. If I don't wanna count commas, I should remove them. If I don't wanna count dots, I should remove them. If I don't wanna count spaces, I should remove them. Let us remove them first. STR18 dot replace. Do you remember? I told you replace method can be used to remove characters. For example, I wanna remove comma. That one. Okay. When you type that code, I am typing nothing for commas. So commas are removed. And then put replace again. Okay. Over here, I will put dots and then nothing. What does it mean? I am telling to Apex, hey Apex, put nothing for dots. Okay. And then one more replace for spaces, everybody. Put over here space and then put nothing. That code will give me a string. Let us name it as pure STR18. It is pure. And then everybody pay attention. System.debug. The number of letters in STR18 is, everybody pay attention, I will get pure string, and then I will use length methods. That's it, everybody. If you want, use length function, put the result into an integer variable. It works. Or put the function directly inside the debug. It works as well. Whichever you want, you can use. Okay, let us execute and see. It says 25. Let us check it if it is correct. I will count 3, 7, 10, 12, 16, 19, 21, 25. It is correct, everybody. Okay. Fethullah used method chain for length as well. It works, no problem. Okay. Is this clear, everybody? After learning functions, everybody, after learning functions, by combining functions, you can do many tasks. Like that one. Can you see by using just replace and length functions, you are able to count letters in a string. It is possible. Okay. Everybody, I told you I will teach you three. I think that's enough. Let us change the subject a little bit. Maybe it is boring for you. I will share the code. We will learn more functions in strings, but for today, that's enough, I think. We learned 17. Review them until Friday. I shared all codes. Okay, those are And then I will delete mine. Pay attention, everybody. Pay attention. Everybody, string is a class in Apex. String is a data type, but at the same time, string is a class. When you put dot, can you see you are able to see methods in the string class? There are many methods. You can look at them. Some of them are very detailed functions. Okay. Don't look at, for example, is alpha, is blank is important, is empty is important. We will learn them, but don't try to learn all details. It can confuse you. Okay. But you should know that one. After typing, everybody, after typing class name, when you put dot, you will see all functions inside the class. In programming language, putting dot means going inside the class. String is a class. When I put dot, I went into the class and I am able to see functions inside the class. It is like that every time, everybody. Okay. For example, let us type date time. This is another class in Apex. When you put dot, you will see all functions inside the date time class. So let us create our own class and then create our functions in it and then check if we can see our functions inside the class. In the first class, I told you how to create a class in Apex. You will come to file, click on file, please. Come to new and then Apex class. Select it, please. It will give you a class automatically. Give a name. Let us name it as test class 01. When you create a class, you need to use uppercase at the beginning. And you need to use uppercase for every word. In camel case, we were making initial in lowercase, but in class names, initial should be in uppercase. And then for every word, you will use camel case rule. First character should be in uppercase. And then click on OK. I have test class 01. It didn't let me. Okay, I will make it test class 02. You can use 01, no problem. Okay. This is my class, everybody. Test class 02. Yours is 01. Everybody, let us test over here. Can we see anything inside it? If you create a test class 01, create 02, no problem. The name is not so important. Test class 02, everybody. This is my class name, like string, like date time. When you put dot over here, I couldn't see anything because my class doesn't have any function. If I create, I will see it. Okay, pay attention. Let us create a function in it. Everybody, to create a function, you need to type public. I will explain what the public is. And then you need to type static. And then you need to type function Okay, public static integer, and then type at. I will type then explain. No worries. You type what I am typing. Put curly braces, press enter. Inside the at, type integer x, integer y, and then type over here, return x plus y. This is the function, everybody. This is the function. Type the code. I will not share. I will explain every word, the meaning of every word. Is it done? In the problems tab, you shouldn't see anything. If there is problems 1, 2, it means you made a mistake. And on the left part, you shouldn't see any exclamation mark. If you see, it means you made a mistake. After typing, please go to file, click on save. Okay. After saving, you shouldn't see any asterisk at the top on the right. If there is no asterisk, there is no exclamation mark, there is no number next to the problems, it means you typed everything correctly. Otherwise, it means you have a mistake. Everybody, let us test it now. Put that over here. Okay, put that, and then type at, open close parenthesis. It will display, but for now it didn't. Let me type it again. Test class 02 dot. Maybe we need to wait. Okay, type at, put semicolon, everybody, and then put over here 3, 5. Everybody, this is addition function. Pay attention, please. This is addition function. What is that function doing? It is getting two integers, as you see. I put 3 for x over here. I put 5 for y over here. And can you see addition method is returning the sum of x and y. So when I execute that code, it should return 8, everybody. It should return 8. 8 is an integer. Because of that, I typed over here integer. What does it mean, everybody? Why did I type over here integer? I am telling to Apex, hey, Apex, my add function will produce integer. Because x plus y is integer, that function will produce integer. In programming language, instead of produce word, we use return. When I tell you add method returns integer, you will understand add function is producing an integer. Because of that, I typed over here integer. If you created a function and your function is producing a string, you need to type over here string. Okay, you will decide it. You will look at your function. If it is producing string, make that one string. If it is producing integer, make that one integer. If it is producing date, make that one date. You can use all data types over here. Okay. Could you understand, everybody, the functionality of that part? Why did I type integer over here? Okay. So my method, add method, will give me 8 over here. 8 is an integer. Let us create an integer container. This is my integer container, everybody. Result. If you want to see result on the console, let us use system.debug. And then I will put result over here. I should see 8 on the console if I execute. Highlight it, execute it. It is sending request, loading content. Can you see? I got 8. I created a method which is adding 2 integers. I put 3, 5, it gave me 8. If you put 30, 50, you will get 80. Okay, everybody, we will talk more about that part. But so far, I was using Apex functions. Right now, I created my own class. I created my own function, and I used it. We didn't create result. What does it mean? Result is a variable. When you type that one, it means you created results. You didn't. Why? Do it, please. Create that one. If you don't create results, you cannot see the 8 on the debug part. Actually, if you want, you can put that one inside the parentheses, but for now, don't do it to make it more understandable. Everybody, pay attention. We talked about that part. Its technical name is, everybody, return type. Okay. That one is return type. How will you decide return type? You will look at the function. And you will understand what the function will produce. According to it, you will type return type over here. Everybody, focus on here. Method doesn't exist, Ali. Did you use public? Did you use static? If you don't use them, you cannot see the method. Everybody, this is the first thing. This is the second thing. Pay attention, please. I know you are tired. Everybody, I know you are tired, but I have 10 minutes, be patient. I will teach you how to create a method. It should work, Ali, there is no any issue. But did you save? After creating method, go to file and save it. Maybe you didn't save it. After every update in Apex, you should save. Okay. Otherwise, it is not visible. Everybody, normally, when you type data type and variable, it means you created a variable. Created variable. That one is variable creation. We learned that one. To create a variable, you would type data type, then a name. This is variable creation. Look at here. This is also variable creation. Created variable. But if you do variable creation inside the method parentheses, they are called parameters. Okay, so those are parameters. Could you understand what the parameter is? If you type integer x outside the method parentheses, it is called variable. But if you type integer x inside the method parentheses, it is called parameters. For some methods, we use parameters. For some methods, we don't use parameters. For example, in string class, everybody, length function doesn't use any parameter, but substring function uses parameter. It is possible. You can put parameters or not. Okay. That one, everybody, look at the green one. This is method name. Okay. This is method name. Everybody, sorry, function name. In Apex, we will use function. Function name. Everybody, function name depends on you. Whatever name you want, you can use. But function names should summarize the functionality. When we learn functions in string class, I told you many times, when you look at the function name, you can understand functionality. When you look at the function name, you can understand the functionality. Everybody, string class created the functions like that. You should create your own functions like that as well. When you create a function, thinking about its name is important. You should put a name as short as possible, but your name should summarize the functionality. Someone, when look at your function, he should be able to understand the functionality. Okay. For example, over here I am doing addition. If I put over here Alican function, it is not sensible. Definitely, they will reject your code and they will tell you what kind of function name is that. Fix it. Okay. If you don't want your code rejected, think the name of the function a little bit. It should summarize the functionality. Okay. Focus on return keyword, everybody. Pink one. Let us make it orange. Look at the return keyword. Everybody, return means that function will produce that one, x plus y. When you call that function, it will give you the sum of x and y. Return means that one. Let us type over here the value which function produced is given to the user by return keyword. If you want to get any value from the function, everybody, you should use return keyword over here. For example, this is add function. User should get the sum of x and y. Because of that, I am typing return x and y. It means give the user x plus y. Okay, this is the return. Let me put a note over here. Return keyword must be in the last line every time. For example, in line 4, I used return keyword. After line 4, I cannot type any other code inside the function. It is impossible. When you type, it will give you error. Because return means give the final value to the user. If it is final thing, you shouldn't type any other code after return. Could you understand the last thing which I tried to explain? Okay. Everybody focus on purple one. Of course, Nazmiye, if you want, don't use any parameter. If you want, use single parameter. If you want, use 10 parameters. We used many methods, Nazmiye. Try to remember, in date time, in new instance methods, we used 6 parameters. Year, month, day, hour, minute, second. Do you remember? We used 6 parameters. If you look at the functions, you will see different number of parameters. Okay. Everybody look at the public. Public means I created a function. Okay. I created a function and it is public. What does it mean? Everyone in the world can use my function. It is open to public. Okay. When you put public at the beginning of a function, it means everyone can use that function. In Turkish, like Sebil. Do you know what the Sebil is? Okay. Look at here, everybody. That one. Public means add function can be used from entire the project. Everybody, when you create an application, your world is project. Every application is a project. If you make something public in the project, it means from every part of the project, you can use add function. Okay, public means that one. And public is called, access modifier. Pay attention, please. Access modifier actually is explaining the functionality of public. For example, I made it public, it means everyone can access. If I make it private, nobody can access because private things belongs to me, like my wallet, like my ID. No one else can use it. They are my privacy. Okay, but I created something. For example, I built a house and I put a label on it, like public house. What does it mean? Everyone can use it. But if I type over there private house, nobody can use it. It is mine. Same logic, everybody. I told you, object-oriented programming languages can try to copy real life. In real life, we have something public, we have something private. In OOP, there is public, there is private. Public is called access modifier, everybody. We have four access modifiers. We will learn them. Not today, but for today, I am teaching you how to create a function. In the function at the beginning, you should type public. Public is an access modifier. If you put public, it means everyone can use it. There is no any restriction on it. Okay, that's it. The last thing, everybody, I take your time, I know, but I should. Let me do that one like that. And then one more color. This is static, everybody. We will talk about access modifiers, about static more, but for now, I want to give you a general information about them. Okay, this is static, everybody. Static means belong to the class. Belong to the class. Pay attention. I told you, everybody. I will take your 5 more minutes and then I will end the class. Everybody, I told you class is a template. This is class. Every time in Java, it is same as well, Alex. Functions, even in Java. No, you are confusing main methods. Every time functions are variables are created in class. Everybody, pay attention, please. This is class. I told you class is a template. And from that class, we can create an object. This is object one, for example. If you want, you can create one more object. There is no any limitation. Object two. Maybe you noticed, everybody, I created many objects in string class. Could you notice str1 was an object, str2, str3, str4. I created many objects. That one is, for example, object 3. All those objects are created from the class. This is template. Those are objects. It is like that. Everybody, when you work in an application, you will have classes, you will have objects. And some things will be belong to class, some things will be belong to objects. For example, everybody, pay attention, please. For example, think the world is a class. Okay, world is a class. This is world. Every people is created from the world. Think it like that. This is Ali. Okay. This is Can. Okay. This is Ali Can. Okay. From the world, three people are created. Everybody pay attention. What do you think about moon? This is moon, everybody. Moon is belong to Can or moon is belong to world? What do you think? Everybody, moon is belong to world. It is that one. Okay. What do you think about I, everybody? I mean that one. I belong to world or belong to Can? What do you think? Belong to Can, that one. Can you see? There are two things, everybody. Some things belong to objects, some things belong to class. Okay. Like moon and I. Everybody, if something belongs to the class, everybody, if something belongs to the class like moon, it is static. Okay. That one is static. If something belongs to the object, it is, everybody, it is instance. Okay, it is instance. Okay, yes, Ali Can is the coding hero in Tech Pro Education, Ali Can Kara. You will like Ali Can because you will hear him many, maybe 3 months. Ali Karacan knows it, I think. Do you remember Ali Can, Ali Karacan? Yes, at the end, we found real Ali Can. He is Ali Can Kara, you are Ali Karacan. There are many combinations. Kara Ali Can, Karacan Ali, Can Kara Ali, Can Ali Kara. You can increase the combination. Ali Osman Karacan. Yes. No, we don't use Osman. We will focus on Ali Can. That's it. Everybody pay attention, please. Okay. Static things, everybody. Static things are belong to the class. What is the benefit of being belong to the class? Everybody. Moon belong to the class, so every person can use moon in the world. Just a single moon is enough for all people. For Can, no need to have moon because world has it. For Ali, no need to have moon because world has it. If something is static, everybody pay attention. Pay attention. I made the add method static. So add method is over here like moon, everybody. Add method is over here like moon. So object tree can easily use it. It will go and use add method. Like Can is using moon, everybody, obj2 will easily use add function because it belongs on the class, like moon, everybody. obj1 can use easily add function. Can you see I created a single function? All objects are able to use it. This is the benefit of making static. If you want a function to be used by all objects, make it static. Just creating once will be enough. I hope it's clear. Okay. We will talk about static more. It is very important concept in programming language, everybody. But for now, I want you to understand static things belong to the class like moon belong to the world. First thing. Second thing, moon can be used all people in the world. Static functions can be used by all objects from the class. Okay, all objects from the class. This is the benefit of creating static functions. Everybody, last thing I will tell you, but I want to share that one at the beginning. Okay. Do you want me to share that image? Now I can clear it. Everybody pay attention. Add method belongs to the class. Because of that, I am typing class name and then accessing to the function. Look at the image in the second image on the left. From the object, I went to the class, then I accessed to the add function. If you wanna access to a static function, you need to use class first, and then you need to access the function. Without using class, you cannot access add function. To go to the moon, you should start the trip from the world. From world, you can go to the moon, okay? If you are in the world. While you are in the world, how will you go to the moon? From world, you will go to the moon. Same thing, everybody. Add belongs to the class. So at the beginning, I should be in the class, then I can go to the function. That's it, okay? Today we talked, we learned many things, everybody. Please review them all. As you see, everything is easy to understand, but there are many things to understand, everybody. There are many things to understand. To remember, if you don't review, you will forget everything. And then you will tell, I will give up. If you give up, you will lose too much money, okay? If you go on to study hard, you can get, after 3 months, too much money. Money is not important, actually, but it is less money. More money is important. For more money, people are fighting, as you know. Okay, see you, everybody.